Alrighty ho. So, hello everybody. Welcome back again. I've already said that, but I'll say it again. So, I was really, really impressed with all of your work. Those people that had posted on Facebook, the drawings that you've been doing, and it seems like you know you really all taken to that technique quite well. And there's, as I said, there's some really gorgeous drawings, and I really enjoyed doing the technique myself. So we're obviously putting charcoal down on the surface first of the paper, and then using a rubber to remove the highlights, then add the tones and shadows afterwards, and then carry on building on top of that. And drawings have come out absolutely brilliantly, and I assume that everybody has seen those on Facebook. But if you haven't, then what I'm planning to do is take some off of there and put them on the website for us all to sort of share a bit more. Okay, so what we're going to do today is we're probably going to spend a bit of time on the drawing part today. Last week what I did is I used a transfer or some carbon paper to transfer an image onto the paper to get straight into the charcoal. This week I thought we'd go we'd work with doing a bit more of the drawing, because it's important to keep building on those skills, and it gives you a little bit of time as well in preparation for the inks and things. So we'll probably we'll see how we go, but I think maybe next week we'll carry on with the inks as well. The other thing is, of course, if you're still working on your charcoal, then please work on that a little bit today. I can see a few of you are busy at the moment, which is really good. Okay, so I'll come over to the table. So this is what we were doing last week. We were, or the first week, I should say. So the first week, I talked about gridding up both your photograph and then gridding up the paper in exactly the same way, and using each small section to then measure and work out where the exact proportions of your portrait goes, or it just helps you get the accuracy anyway, doesn't it? So if you want to use those techniques today to draw out your next portrait, then go for it. What I've said a few minutes ago is that I'm going to be drawing freehand today, which takes a little bit more time sometimes, but in a sense a grid tightens you up quite a lot. And this drawing freehand allows you to loosen up, and it kind of starts to build a bit of confidence in the fact that you can do these things, you know, just drawing them straight out. Yes, it does take a lot of practice, but it is worth doing because it does build your skills as in drawing as well. So this is what we did last week then in the lesson. On this particular drawing, you can see all the outlines from when I used the carbon paper. And then I started to add the tones and shadows in. But as you can see the highlights have been removed from the charcoal and then worked back into with the darker areas, adding the shadows back in. And I put this on the website. So if you did miss it or you want to have a recap on what I did, then I've put that on the website for you to watch again. On Tuesday, I did another portrait of Humphrey Bogart, and I used exactly the same techniques, but I did get a little bit farther in that I added some darker tones and some extra details into this one. So the other thing that I also did that I wanted just to share with you is that I used a white charcoal pencil, which is this one. I used that came with the set, and when I wanted to add some more details into the hair here, I pressed down quite hard with a pencil and then kind of flicked off some of these hairs to get those finer details, and then of course you can work in some of the white areas on the highlights to really push those out so that you've got much cleaner kind of white area on there. All right, so if you want to carry on working with that, that's absolutely fantastic. Okay, so I'm going to move that one over there. All right, so there's an eye on there at the moment. Right, so I'm just going to do a very quick demo of using the inks. trying to get the better positions. So back in the summer we did do an ink exercise and I drew this kind of bulldog thing, and if you remember that then you'll remember a lot of this, what I'm going to just do right now. So with ink, you've got I've got a couple of types of ink here. I've got this quink ink, which has kind of a bluey tinge to it when you add water. Quink ink is not permanent. So basically, if you add water to it after you've painted it and it's dried off, it will bleed again. So it's not permanent in the same way that Winsor & Newton Indian ink is. Indian ink's a bit more permanent. So if you're building up successive layers of tones using water and the ink, then once they're dry and they stay as they are. So depending on what you've got, it may change slightly the way that you work, but I wouldn't have thought overly too much. But it's just worth sometimes recognizing some of these different qualities. I'm going to use the quink ink to do a little bit of shading here. So I've got my jar of water and I've got a plate here to mix my inks on, and I've got a nice round brush, a watercolor brush actually. So I'm just going to put in, so we've got, this is the pure color or ink just here. And then all you do basically is just add a touch of water and then put down your next tone. And you can get it, this is worth doing because it just gives you, if you, even if you've done it before, it gives you a feel for the medium that you're using. And then we'll add a little bit more water. Hope you can all see that. So we're just getting a little bit lighter each time, add more water and so on. So it's very much similar to, in a way, to watercolor. And if you haven't got any ink, you can always use a little bit of watercolor to do this instead. It's just a case of mixing the watercolor on your plate to a nice strong mix the pigments nice and strong on the plate. And then obviously add water and test it on a spare sheet of paper as you're working. All right. Okay. And then you're almost just adding water from the pot. So you've got a lovely tonal range there to work from. And it, if you try that, if you just do that as a little practice, it'll give you a good feeling for the ink, even if you've done it a few times before. Okay, so I'm just going to go over to the wall just here. So I picked out and I put some of these on the website already. This is for something else a little bit later on, but what I've got here is a couple of examples of this was actually done in watercolor, but you could easily do this with the ink because it's a similar sort of technique. But you've got this these lovely clean washes that have then been diluted with a bit of extra water in places. And mainly, as you can see, the shadows have been painted. And then the highlights have been left almost kind of empty. So you've got a really nice strong contrast and a good sense of light in the picture as well just there. So this is the kind of thing we're looking at the moment. And then this one, which I think looks a bit like Yoko Ono. It does, yeah. It's got a little bit of colour on here. So I think perhaps, I'm not sure. No, it is a painting. It's not water. It's not a computer one. But it's got a little bit of brown in there as well. So it may be that... certain ink has been used, maybe an Indian ink on that one as well. So, but you can see how the artist has created this sense of light around the edge of the face or the hair, where it's got a little bit lighter on there. And part of me suspects there's a little bit of bleach going on in there as well. Watered down bleach, create that sense of light in there. Okay, now these are, I've got a couple of photos that I'm gonna be working on today. So I've got this one because you've got nice contrasting shadow to the left of the head, and then the light's obviously coming in from the right and casting these really nice shadows, and there's a little bit of detail there in the eyes as well. And this, I've forgotten the name of the actor. And then over here, another actor who I can't remember the name of either. I think it's Yakim somebody. I think he was in Batman or something like that recently. And
Working Phoenix.
Joaquin, that's it. Yeah, that's him. Yeah. So I've chosen this one because you've got this kind of heavy shadow around the brows. You've got this nice beard, and you've got some detail in the bottom bit where he's going a bit grey. So I thought that would be a nice one too. And you've also got some strong highlights and medium tones in there as well. So what I'm going to do today is I'm going to start by drawing this port one of these portraits out by hand rather than with a grid. And then once we've done that, I'll start working in and I'll talk through what I'm doing as I do it, if I get to that stage, which I should do. I'll talk through using how I'm going to use the inks. But there are a few different ways of using inks. You can start really pale. So you can just, a bit like with the when we were doing watercolors, you can just patch in some very light tones to begin with a watered down ink. So it gives you an idea of where all the tones are going to be, even if they're not like really dark at that point, but they need to be later. It starts to just give you a bit of room to put the tones in without committing fully to begin with. And then once they're kind of drying off a bit, you can then start applying the next layers of ink back over the top of that. Okay, so I'll talk obviously in detail a bit more about inks as we use them a bit later. But first of all, we'll focus on drawing. There was something else I wanted to show you actually. Let's just come over here and zoom out again. So got this. I mean, if you enjoy inks, I found this way to get the books out, but this is a really nice book. It's actually quite old now. It's published in 1992, so it's pre-digital. But there's a lot of detail in this book about materials and techniques you can use. Everything from cross hatching to different nibs you can use to draw with. And I was I thought this was a really nice book. It's got some different types of drawings, different approaches to using inks, like freer drawing. And this one over here, just down here, is one that reminded me of a drawing that I've done recently in my own book. It uses lines that have been condensed together in places to add more tone to the picture, and the lines are all going in a similar direction. So this is something that I've tried out in my own sketchbook. So I've drawn these lines direct down. It is going off the subject of inks a little bit, but it is using ink in a sense as well. So these are things that you can add on top of an ink wash drawing that we're going to try out next. I just got all enthusiastic about these drawings. So, and this is another one in biro with scribbles. That's a biro one as well. And then a little bit further on, this was a pen drawing, and I've used watercolor washes over the top afterwards. And shadows and things. This is also a lovely photograph that I found. So we've got again a bit like that one of Joaquin that we saw earlier. We've got the light hitting the side of the face and these nice deep shadows. But then just to add a little bit of color in there to really draw the attention a bit more as well. So I just thought I'd show you those really. So the book is it's called The Pen and Ink Book by Joss A. Smith. And it's really inspiring to have a look at, even though it's quite an old book now. It's just a nice little find. Okay, so Drawing first. If you want to go for using the grid, please do that. I'm going to be drawing using my using the eyes. So has anyone got any questions at this stage? Brilliant. Brilliant.
Now, so done the
yep.
Good.
Oh, hang on. Sorry, hold on a minute. I've just got to sort this out so I can see you. There you go. Right. Oh, right. Yeah. Okay. So you've got a view from underneath the head, haven't you? There.
It's yeah. The one off the website.
Oh, is it? Okay. Okay. I think couldn't remember that one. Yeah. Looks good. Yeah. So, did you start? How have you started it? Did you draw just straight off freehand?
I've done it with a grid.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. That's good.
And I have.
Ooh.
These things.
Ah, magic colour. I've not used those ones before. Do you know if they're waterproof?
I don't think so.
Okay. Yeah. So, you have to bear that in mind when you're working with putting more layers of ink over the top. Yeah. Yeah.
That's what I was thinking when you said that.
Yeah.
Okay.
So remember what I said, start light and then build in with the darker tones as you work.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Are you going now with the inks, are you? Or are you going to draw a bit more?
I'm trying to.
You're going to, what, with the inks?
Or...
Yeah. Yeah. Oh, go for it then. Okay.
Thank you.
All right. Hi there, Sonia. I hope you're right. You caught all of that.
Hi, Jamie. I haven't got any inks, so I'll
probably
just do another pencil one.
Okay, cool. You can use watercolour to do this, though. So don't, don't feel like you can't do it, because you could quite easily use watercolours to do this, okay?
Okay. I'll draw it out tonight and see how far I can get
anyway. Yeah, that's what I thought we'd do this evening. Okay. Just have a bit more time with the drawing.
Did you see the other one I finished?
Which one was it?
Hang on.
I'll just
That's ever so big.
Oh yeah. Yeah, I did see that one. We talked about it a bit last week, didn't we?
I finished her off.
Yeah, well done. Nice.
Let's have a look. I missed it. I didn't realise it was that
Yeah,
big.
You've got a lot more tone. You've got more tone and definition in there, I think, now, haven't you, as well? Yeah. Yeah, beautiful.
Nice. Yeah. Just wanted.
Oh, sorry, I missed that.
No. It's all right.
Yeah, well done.
So, you know that psalm I did, Jamie, with all my painting pictures in the church?
Yeah.
I showed it in RE today at school. The kids go, oh, you've done all that art, Miss. Miss goes to school too on Monday night.
Hey, that's great.
And they're all going, Miss, will you draw me this? Miss, will you draw me that? I said, no, I don't know. I've got time. I've got to do my lessons.
Yeah, exactly.
I've got to teach you lot all day long.
Was that when you were in school then, was it?
Yeah. They've got to write their own psalm in RE.
Oh, brilliant.
So I'll show them my psalm that I wrote for church with all my artwork. And they were like, their jaws were literally dropping to the table. Yes, you do that. Yeah.
Yeah.
Really nice.
Yeah, I remember you showing it on the call, on the Zoom call at church.
They were very impressed with them. So I've got to take my art book in to show them tomorrow.
Oh, bless them. That's good. Oh, it's good to know you're inspiring people.
Yeah, I've got a few budding artists in the class actually, so they like it that I'm still learning at my age, so there you go.
Yeah.
Well, that's good.
Lifelong learning, they call it, don't they?
Yeah, bless them. Right, I'll go and mute now.
Okie doke. So I've been in here all day.